Hello everyone. Today we will know about voltage division using active resistor or getting a DC voltage drop using active resistors. So let's see. So I have taken an example which shows that the use of an N-channel MOS active resistor and P-channel MOS active resistor. So there are two transistors, one is M1 and M2. This is N-channel and this is M2 is P-channel. This is they both are used to provide a DC voltage drop V out. We need to find W by L ratio for M1 and M2. It gives a voltage drop V out of 1 volt. So V out is this 1 volt. Okay, VDD is given 5 volt. Let me write it down. This is VSS is given minus 5 volt. Okay, current I is given 50 microampere. Okay, threshold voltage for VTN. VT is 0.75. And we know for this P channel type, VT is minus 0.75. Okay, KN constant is given, this 2.4 into 10 to the power minus 5, and for KP it is given. So first, in this type of example, we need to find whether the transistors are working in saturation mode or in triode region. So let us see. Okay, as we know, this gate terminal is connected to one of the terminal. So let us see that which is the terminal. So before finding whether the transistor is in saturation or triode region, we first find that which terminal is drain and which terminal is source in both M1 and M2. We know that in NMOS, source should be at lower potential. So source should be at lower potential. For M1 transistor, for this NMOS transistor, this VSS is this terminal is at minus 5 and this terminal is 1 volt. So this terminal at lower potential, this is source and this is drain. Okay. Similarly, for M2, drain must be at lower potential. So this should be drain and this should be source. Okay. Now, in both the cases, M1 and M2, the drain is connected to the gate terminal. When the drain is connected to the gate terminal, we have already seen in our last lecture that the transistors are known as to be in saturation mode. So M1 and M2 are in saturation mode. M1 and M2 are in saturation mode. So we need to find W by L. We know the saturation current is written as Kn dash W by L to VGS minus VT whole square. Simply substituting all the values and finding W by L ratio. So W by L ratio for NMOS. For NMOS, W by L ratio can be written as 2ID upon Kn dash VGS minus VT whole square. It can be find it out as 2 into ID is given 50 microampere to 10 to the power minus 6 upon Kn dash is given 2.4 into 10 to the power minus 6, minus 5, sorry, minus 5. This VGS is given, VGS. Now VGS in case of N, we know VG is to be 1 volt and VS is minus 5. So VG minus VS, 1 minus of minus 5 will give us 6 volt. So we can write 6 minus Vt is 0.75 whole square. And W by L ratio came out to be 0.15. For PMOS, similarly for PMOS, we can find for PMOS VGS. First, we need to find VGS. This is VG minus VDD because VG, this VG minus VS, that VS is connected to VDD, that is 5 volt. So 1 minus 5 came out to be minus 4. Okay, W by L ratio, substituting all the values similar to the NMOS, 50 microampere, 2.8, 10 to the power minus 5 into minus 4 minus of minus 0.75 whole square. This came out to be 1.1. So this is the answer for PMOS, W by L is 1.18, and for NMOS it is 0.15. Okay. So this is all in this lecture. Thank you.